session drummer, the late Greg Phillinganes, was a major player on the album, as was fellow Toto band member, guitarist STEVE LUKATHER. Because the doggone girl is
mine. Greg and I got a call to work with Quincy on the Thriller record. It says a duet with Paul McCartney. First time we met Paul, who was a wonderful, beautiful cat, and one of my all-time heroes. And Michael Jackson and Paul McCartney are going to do a duet together. Quincy sent over a cassette to Jeff. And Jeff goes, "Look, come on over, man. Let's sit down and dig the tune, man. Let's, you know, Paul and Michael, this is going to be incredible, man, you know." So we sit down, and we're just going like, this is going to be absolutely fantastic, man. And and the song starts. He goes, "The doggone girl is mine." And if I could have a camera to look on Jeff's face, man, we fell out, man. We fell out. We were cracking up at the lyric, "The doggone girl is mine."
The song reached number 2 in the States and number 8 in Britain. STEVE LUKATHER.
My buddy Eddie Van Halen, they wanted him to do a solo on it. Quincy called Eddie, who Eddie kept hanging up on Quincy until he figured out who Quincy Jones was, because Eddie's Dutch, rock and roll giant, one of the best guitar players ever.
I kept calling Eddie, and who is it? I said, "Quincy Jones." He said, "F off, boom." I called him 4 times. He didn't believe it was me. I said, "Tell us, Turkey, I'm calling me. It is me, you know." And he came, "Oh, I'm sorry, man." And he finally came on in, and he put it away, man, like 2 hours in there.
Putting him on Beat It, you know, with the two Gibson speakers, you know, and two little six-packs of beer. And Bruce is calling from next door, and he's put the speakers on fire because he's mixing Beat It, you know, there's stuff going on everywhere.
At that point, I never thought this was going to be a big, like, single like that. And Eddie, I don't think he even got paid for the date. To this day, he still talks about that. He's like, "This guys didn't even pay me scale." But that gave Michael rock credibility at rock radio, and that's what they were trying to do, was cross over.
The song and its video crossed right over to MTV, making Jackson their number one artist. Becoming a TV and music sensation also brought problems that Jackson had to learn to deal with. Here's keyboard player and Jackson's friend, Greg Phillinganes.
One day, during one of the sessions, we had some downtime. There was something wrong with the recording desk. And so it was going to be a while, so Michael was getting a little bored. So he said to me, he says, "Let's go across the street, let's go shopping." So he put on a disguise. He put on a big Afro wig and these funky, jacked up teeth and dark sunglasses. And we walked out of the studio and we crossed the street to the Beverly Center. And as we're crossing, I'm thinking to myself, I'm crossing the street with Michael Jackson, and it's just the two of us. No security, nothing. And we walked in the Beverly Center, and we looked around. I'm not looking at him, I'm looking at the people. And he bought a couple things, and I think he bought a watch or something like that. And the girl at the counter was like, "Thank you." She wasn't really sure, but as we walked away, she finally realized who it was. And then so we finally started getting a little crowd, then we left. No security, no big hassles, we just calmly walked out.
You could say a song called Human Nature was perfect then for the album, but it only found its way onto Thriller by accident. The song was written by Greg Phillinganes, who'd just left Toto, band members STEVE LUKATHER and Mike Porcaro.
Human Nature for Michael Jackson was a big one, and it's funny because, like, that happened like within months of his leaving the band. He had the hook, and he would play it all the time and stuff like that. And at that point, we were going, "Oh no, man, we want to be more rock and roll." And he kept that one in his trick bag.
Sleep as I hear her voice shake my window, sweet seducing sighs.
They sent over two demos to things they felt would be right for Michael. And we left the tape on, and all of a sudden, at the end, there was all this silence, and it said, why? And I said, what the hell is that? This is where we want to go because it's got such a wonderful flavor.
Reaching out, touch a stranger. Electric eyes are everywhere. See that girl, she knows I'm watching. She likes the way I stare. And they say, why?
Cutting Thriller, we were all on that record. He whipped that one out and finished it, and we were all going, oh.
That tune may not have been right for Toto at the time, and also it may have been cut to perfection for Toto at the time and still not been a hit. I mean, it's so arbitrary, and it's the right combination of elements and talent and the voice singing it that could make a tune fly or not fly. So fact remains, it was a great accomplishment for him and a big song for Michael.
Why? Tell him that it's your nature.